Welcome to week seven. Clearly, we've been going at this for a while. My hair is getting a little longer. Pretty soon, I'll start taking off these sweaters. It's actually beautiful weather here in Austin right now. What we talked about last week was how to compute the solution to AX equals B via LU factorization. And the astute participant will have noticed that our algorithms may incur a divide by zero. And the examples that we happen to look at never had that happen. So this week, we start by discussing how to get around that problem when it occurs in the cases where the problem is with the linear system and or the matrix. And then we're going to start talking about invertible matrices, in other words, matrices for which we can find an inverse. And the way we're going to introduce that is by first looking at inverses of matrices that just map a real to a real. And then we'll discuss inverses of vector functions, inverses of linear transformations, and then finally, inverses of matrices. That then sets us up to wrap things up as far as inverting matrices and finding solutions to linear systems next week. And that then puts us at a point in the course where we can have an exam. So we've seen Gaussian elimination, and we've seen LU factorization, and we've seen how to use both to solve linear systems. And a question that comes up is, will it always find a solution, and will that solution be unique? And that's a topic that we're going to be talking about over the next few weeks. Now let's think for a second about a system of linear equations. In this case, we have three equations in three unknowns. And one way to think about that is to think of each of those equations as defining a plane. And the question that we're trying to ask is, where do those planes intersect? Now, if there is a unique solution, then what that means is that the planes intersect in a point, as illustrated right here. And I found this picture on Wikipedia, and unfortunately, when I went back to try to find the proper source for it so I could cite it, I could not find that, so I apologize to the author of this picture. And you can imagine that if each of these equations defines a plane, then there is the possibility that these planes do not intersect, for example, if they're all parallel, or only two of the planes intersect, or all the three planes intersect in a line, etc., etc. So these are all interesting topics that we're going to be talking about in the future. And of course, we're going to talk about these in more general terms than two dimensions or three dimensions. So the fundamental question this week is, when does AX equals B have a solution? And if it has a unique solution, then there is something called an inverse matrix to the matrix A. And that's what we're going to start on in the second half of this week. The first half, we're going to tie this question to the Gaussian elimination and LU factorization that we saw last week. So then the next few weeks, we're going to look at things like, when does it have no solution, and when does it have many solutions? But let's just stick to the case where it has a unique solution for now.